everybody, Cutthroat Cure here, bringing to you another Advanced Maneuvers Quick Tip Tutorial. In today's Quick Tip Tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to build this efficient and cheap paint rack that you can build to whatever workstation you have and hold whatever kind of paints you need. Now, mainly, as you will see here, my paint rack holds mainly Vallejo and dropper bottle paints. I will also be using today a new technique to try and hold the P3 range of paints. So let's get to building. When building your PVC paint rack, there's going to be a few items that you need. Now, all of these items are slightly inexpensive, and once you have some of them, you should be able to use it to build a rack about the size of mine. Today, I'm going to be building something a little bit smaller, using 6 pipes of one type and 6 pipes of the other. The important things you're going to need for this video is going to be Odie medium clear PVC cement. I got this at Lowe's. It was $4.98. You're going to need a pair of Brass Craft PVC cutters. This is a tool that you can use many, many times. Throw in a toolbox. This I also got at Lowe's. It was $12.98, and I have used it in making 3 racks so far. You're going to need multitude sizing of PVC pipes. The 2 types of pipe that I went with is a 1 inch by 10 foot long SCH40 PVC pipe. This is going to be really good for your dropper bottles and Vallejo type paints. As you can see, the paints easily go in there, and it leaves a little bit of room for you to pull the paints out. And then the other size of piping I'm going to be using is going to be a 1 inch by 10 foot long 200 PSI. Now, the 2 pipes vary in pricings, but for a 10 foot piece, I paid $3.81 for the dropper bottle paint, and I paid $2.67 for the one I will be using for the P3 paints. Another thing you're going to be needing is some sort of paper towel in case you have a mess or something. I'm just going to use something that I was painting with, since I'm going to throw it away anyways. You're also going to need a Expo dry erase marker. You should have one of these if you're used to marking cards. And you're also going to need a ruler or a tape measure, which you should have in your army bag anyways. Now, to make things more simple, I went ahead and pre-measured and pre-cut this piece of PVC. I cut this at 2.5 inches for dropper bottles. I realized when I had built my first PVC paint rack that I had cut the pipes a little bit too long, and so therefore it made the bottles a little bit harder to get out. In further experimenting and playing around with the ideas, I found that 2.5 inches on the PVC pipes fits perfectly and allows me to put the bottles in and still allow plenty of room to pull them out. Another thing you're going to need is some sort of flat surface. Today I'm going to be using this piece of cardboard that I have blue tacked to my desk. A board would work, a wall, a lot of things like that. You also, since you're going to be dealing with the PVC cement, you might want to put something down that's going to allow you to maybe not make a mess. It's pretty clean, and I didn't have a lot of issue. I actually did this in my dining room the first time, but you know, better safe than sorry, especially if you're dealing with a husband or wife who doesn't like a mess. So the first thing I want to show you is exactly how you're going to cut the pipe. Now, as you see, I made a mark here using the Expo marker in order to let myself know what sizing I was going for. So you're going to put the pipe into the PVC cutter. You're going to click until you actually feel it bite down. As you can see, it's biting down right there, all right on the mark. And then basically, you're just going to squeeze and keep pressing these down until you've cut through the pipe. And there you go, you've got 2 2.5 inch pieces that are going to be really good for using as we continue this. Once you're done with all the setup and you know about how many paints and tubes you're going to need, then you're going to want to start assembling the kit. So what I like to do in order to make sure that my paint rack is a little bit more sturdy, I like to put the thicker and heavier pipes on the bottom. Now you're going to have to create a basic structure to attach all the other pipes to. So what I suggest is taking maybe two of the pipes, you know, get yourself a little bit of this cement on it, wipe it off. And then what you're going to want to do is you're just going to want to smear it on one side, like so. And then you're going to take this other pipe and then you're going to simply just push the two together and push them against your flat surface and hold them. Now, it doesn't take a long time for them to set, but once they do, you're not going to have too many issues with that. So as I said, you're just going to hold it, let it set for a second, push it against this so they stay flat on the front, and that way when your paint rack is complete, that, you know, you can see everything and everything seems to stick out about the same distance. Now once you have that basically setting, as you can see, you're going to have a little bit of structure. Now this is a little bit wet, and for the sake of keeping this a quick tip tutorial, I'm going to speed up the process. You might want to allow just a little bit of a longer time for them to set, but once they do set, it will become one solid piece. And what you're just going to end up doing is you're just going to rinse and repeat this process. You're just going to take a little bit of the cement, you know, and you're going to want to, you know, when you're doing a top piece, you're just going to kind of want to wipe it. And then you're going to take the next piece of tubing that you have and just drop it in. And as you can see, we're already getting kind of a honeycomb effect that's allowing us to, you know, build onto. And you can build it out long ways. You can build it out, you know, high. A good thing I like about this, and I haven't gotten to try yet, is the fact that if you would want to build like a fun shape, like maybe like a zigzag or like a wave or maybe some sort of fun design, that's possible. Hopefully in a future video or future content, you know, we can create something that'll be, you know, more of a fun shape. But for now, we're just going for the basics. Now, as you see, I've already got three tubes connected to each other, and right there, you know, that's gonna hold three paints for me to pull what I need. Now I'm gonna speed this process up a little bit so that, as I said, we can get this done in a good amount of time, and that way you, the viewer, can watch this and get right back to work. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put this on either side because I've got the ability to, and then I'm gonna take two pipes and I'm just gonna push them against here, and I'm just gonna hold it all together. Now, as I said, a little bit of pressure is gonna make it, you know, is gonna speed up the process a little bit, and just having this flat surface on the back is going to make sure that everything stays flush. And so when your paint rack is complete, you know, looking at them and pulling out a paint of the size you need is going to, you know, be a lot more simple. And there we go. And now I'm gonna move on to the next two pieces. Now once you start moving up a little bit in the sizing, you're gonna come into a thing where if you don't let it set it with enough time, it has the possibility of separating a little bit. But once you start getting the hang of it, you'll kind of get down a system that'll work, and you're not going to see too many issues with that. So, and I'm just gonna put a little bit more cement on here. The cool part about this idea is that, you know, by getting the 10 foot long pipes, it's gonna give you more than enough. And in a lot of cases, you get two of those, you know, you're building a paint rack for right around, with all the tools and stuff, your first paint rack might cost you about $20. But one of the neat and interesting parts about this idea is the fact that if you realize that you need more space or you need more paints, the paint rack can grow with you. So you can always go back to an existing paint rack and you can add on to it just by getting a little bit more piping and a little bit more cement and then building onto it. So you basically get a paint rack that grows as you grow as an artist. So here we go, we're gonna attach the last piece of the longer PVC. And as I said, I'm going with kind of just like an awkward, interesting shape just to show you some of the ability. I'm gonna clean this up with my paper towel and attach this piece here. Once again, pushing it firmly against my back piece so that I get that flush design that we've talked about. Now, once again, when you're cutting through these, your piping isn't gonna be perfect. It's not gonna always be the most flush thing. You're going for a very general idea. So don't, you know, stress yourself out too much or worry too much about everything being exactly the same size. As long as all of the piping is right around 2.5 inches, then you shouldn't have an issue. And being able to, you know, move it around a little bit and adjust them is going to be really beneficial for you. All right, so now that I have my basic structure, you can see that already I'm able to lift this up. I'm gonna clean this little bit of mess here off. But now you can already see that my paint rack, in a simple like 6 minutes, I've already got enough to do 8 paints here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set this back up and I'm gonna pull from over here my smaller P3 paints. Now, as I said, this is something new I haven't really tried yet. I picked this 200 PSI piping due to its 1-inch sizing because of the fact that P3 paints with their wide bases and this little hook on the cap, it makes it a little bit harder. As you can see, they will not go into these smaller ones, but due to the thinner walls on the 200 PSI, you're able to slide that in there. Now, one thing I did notice when I cut these with the PVC cutter is that because of the thin walls, the piping likes to bend, and you can see a little bit of that bending right here. Let me see if I can get that. There you go. You can see a little bit of the bending there. What I ended up doing is after I cut a lot of these pieces, now I did try this 2 different ways. I did try to cut it with the PVC cutter that I showed you, and then I tried cutting it with a PVC saw, and I actually found that the PVC saw was able to cut it in a more direct pattern, but it took forever. I was able to do 4 pieces, and they were pretty accurate, but I don't think that the amount of time it took for that little bit of accuracy is gonna work in this. So going through and cutting these with the Brass Craft PVC cutter, I think is just going to be easier. And you just might wanna have a pair of pliers or like a monkey wrench or something just to get a good hold on these and just kind of straighten them out the best you can. Now, as you can see, once again, here's P3 paint, here's the tubing. You can push that in there. It's gonna be a snug fit. But the good news about that is that once you have the backing on this, it's going to be flush. The only thing about the P3 paints is that you're probably going to have to paint the cap, because due to this little slip here to make opening the bottle a little bit easier, it doesn't slide in as simply, and cutting that off is going to make the bottle a lot harder to open. So what you might want to end up doing is paint this white area of the cap so that you can see your paints as easily as you do with the dropper bottles. Now, I'm gonna pull this out and I'm gonna build onto my paint rack. So here we go. I'm just grabbing a little bit more of the cement and we are going to learn. So I'm gonna put it on the back here just so I can use the front of the paint rack right here as the basis. And also because once I put a back on it, so one of the things I would definitely suggest is find something that you want to use for a backing. I used an old politician's sign that somebody had left on the side of the road. I had found that and I cut that down, and that's what I used for my original 2 paint racks I've done so far. I'm making a little bit of a mess here. But I definitely suggest that just because of the fact that, most people are gonna throw those away, and it can easily help you create a flush back for your PVC so the bottles don't pour out the back. So I'm just gonna set these up here, push that against that. And as you can see, because both of the pipings are technically considered the 1-inch piping, they're gonna fit in the general same area. So what this allows me to do is keep using the same angles and keep using the same, you know, setup to build onto my paint rack. So here I go, I'm just putting a little bit more cement there, grab another bottle, another pipe, I'm just gonna push that right in there. And hopefully the cement, since will hold these in such a manner that that's going to work. I have really enjoyed building these, and I know that on the War Machine and Hordes Facebook painting group, I had a lot of people ask me about building these, and I tried to come up with a little bit of a written description, but you know, some people like videos a little bit better, so you know, we figured, what the heck. So right there, we're already coming ahead. Going to get a little bit of this last glue. We're gonna finish this bad boy up. So boom, put a little bit there, a little bit there. As I said, you know, you're gonna want the paper towel to make sure that you're, you know, so that you're cleaning up your messes so you're not making too much of an issue. But I'm gonna put a little bit on the side here and clean my hand off, push it against, once again, our thing to keep the flat base. Push it back. Gonna hold it for a second. And we're gonna pull off, clean it up a little bit, because I am making one heck of a mess when I do this. And there we go. In under 15 minutes, I have now made a paint rack that will hold, let's see, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14 paints. And if I have one more piece, we can make it a fun 15. And as you can see, just grabbing some paints here, you can see that easily I have set all these paints in here. As I said, you're going to want to possibly paint the white caps unless you are okay with looking at the sides of them. I would suggest painting the caps just because it makes it a little bit easier. And once this settles, pulling the paints out of it is going to be a lot easier. But there you go. And there you go, our fun little paint rack. So once again, guys, if you enjoyed this, hopefully that you can build for your friends a few PVC paint racks, and hopefully Advanced Maneuvers can, like the paint rack, grow with you as you grow as an artist. So thanks for tuning in. If you enjoyed this Advanced Maneuvers hobby content, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And let us know what future tips and tricks and hobby-related materials you would like to see. Don't forget, it just takes one brushstroke to keep getting better.